A local concert promoter has been arrested for fraud. 56-year-old Turk Cazimero was arrested early this morning and charged with wire fraud. According to the federal indictment, Cazimero is accused of taking $638,000 from families who thought they were investing in concerts and events that never happened. Concert promoters are not required to be licensed in Hawaii. And this is not the first time something like this has happened. So we sent Bridget Namata to find out if that should change. Bridget?
Joe, I learned this investigation was a joint effort by both state and federal authorities who have been investigating Turk Cazimero for nearly 2 years now. And authorities say there could be more victims out there.
Six local families, $638,000 later, Turk Cazimero was arrested early this morning and spent the afternoon in federal court. Investigators say between 2013 to 2015, Cazimero convinced victims into investing in his events. He promised sponsorships and profits.
The indictment lists events Cazimero claimed to promote to get money from investors. A rodeo in Waimanalo, a national music festival sponsored by Vans, and other events and concerts from big-name artists.
But according to FBI Special Agent Tom Simon,
there was no such thing as the Vans Warped DJ Tour, and the indictment also alleges that Mr. Cazimero spent all this money on himself.
I was contacted by a woman who, though she wants to stay anonymous, says she gave Cazimero money, $100,000 of her life savings, on concerts that never happened.
So basically it left me with nothing. And the stress level was so high, you know, because you work all your life and then it's all gone. It just dragged on and on and on, and the piece he doing, everything was gone. He had a way of talking. He must have done this for years.
In Hawaii, anyone can call themselves a concert promoter. I reached out to the DCCA and asked,
do you think something needs to change to prevent things from happening? Do you think there needs to be regulation on this?
That's something we could certainly take a look at. I mean, since I've been doing this, it's been a really long time. There have been a few instances in which concert promoters haven't gone through with the way they said that they were going to promote a concert.
Authorities charged the Waimanalo man with 3 counts of wire fraud, $3,800 to a credit card data processing contractor, $30,000 to State Farm Bank for a car loan, and $75,000 to an investment company.
Turk Cazimero pled not guilty to the charges and released on $50,000 bond. His trial is set for June. Special Agent Simon says there could be more victims out there. You're asked to contact the FBI. I'll put a link on our website, khon.com. Back to you, Joe.